Welcome to the Dog Solid Channel, and today we are going over the top pros and cons of owning the Alaskan Kleekais. Make sure to watch all the way to the end of the video to make sure that you don't miss any valuable information. The miniature Alaskan Kleekais may mimic several characteristics of the Alaskan and Siberian Huskies, who they are descended from, but they have so many obvious differences. Created as companion dogs, instead of a working breed that pulls sleds, Alaskan Kleekais are very loving, but they are very wary of strangers, which makes them good watchdogs. The Alaskan Kleekais is highly trainable and eager to please, as they crave attention from their humans. Currently, the American Kennel Club does not recognize this breed since they are a relatively rare breed. However, they are recognized by several other kennel clubs, and many breed standards have been established. Without further ado, let's dive into the video. History. Hailing from Alaska, the Alaskan Kleekai was created around the early 1970s. Linda Sperlin is given credit as creator of this spunky breed. Linda's sole purpose of creating the Alaskan Kleekai was to create a dog that would be an amazing companion dog. One of the unique qualities of Linda's breeding style was that she did not use dogs that suffered from dwarfism to create this smaller breed. Instead, she bred Siberian and Alaskan Huskies with breeds like the Shipperk and Alaskan Eskimo Dog to reduce the size of the puppies. In 1988, Sperlin debuted this breed to the public, and originally she named the breed Kleekai, which is an Inuit term meaning small dog. It was renamed the Alaskan Kleekai in 1995. Sperlin has long retired from breeding, but there are still a number of breeders that continue to breed the Alaskan Kleekai, which is why the breed remains rare. Temperament. The Alaskan Kleekais are considered to be intelligent, energetic, and loving to their families. Being the center of attention is what the Kleekais love the most, and if their needs are not being met, they are not shy to let you know. Even though these miniature breeds tend to whine to show their displeasures, they are much quieter than the Husky when it comes to barking and being overly mouthy. Just like other smaller breeds, the Alaskan Kleekais tend to be alert and territorial, which makes them excellent watchdogs. Since the Kleekais are territorial, they do not care for strangers and will require lifelong socialization training if they are to be friendly to new people. Interaction with children and other pets. The Alaskan Kleekais, in general, are loving family pets that get along great with children of the family. However, they can get skittish around small kids and strangers, so it's important to socialize your Alaskan Kleekai from an early age. With small dogs, children must be taught how to interact with small breeds, as they may injure or provoke Alaskan Kleekais to nip. It's always wise to supervise children when playing with Kleekai. This small husky is usually good with other dogs, especially if they've been socialized as puppies at an early age. Since this breed inherits a high prey drive, it makes them unsuitable to live with smaller pets unless they have been trained to live with them. Training. The intelligent Alaskan Kleekais are quick learners as they tend to pick up commands more easily than that of their average dog breed. This breed is highly motivated as they are eager to please. This trait also makes them excellent agility dogs. For exercise, it is necessary that the Kleekais have at least a good long walk and a healthy play session in order to burn off some of that little dog energy throughout the day. If their excessive needs are not maintained, the Alaskan Kleekais may become bored, anxious, and destructive. Once they've had their daily exercise, the small husky breed is happy to be a couch potato for the rest of the day. One great way to exercise the Alaskan Kleekai is to sign them up for an agility class or build a homemade agility course in your backyard if you have the space. Size. This energetic breed comes in three sizes: toy, miniature, and standard. There isn't that much difference in these sizes. The toy size grows to a height of 13 inches, the miniature size can grow to a height over 13 inches and up to 15 inches, and the standard size can grow over 15 inches and up to 17 inches. Most Alaskan Kleekais are between 10 and 15 pounds, 4 to 9 kilograms, though there can be some as small as 5 pounds or as large as 22 pounds. Coat. The Alaskan Kleekais will have the recognizable face mask of the Husky. Their coats are considered to be a standard double coat. Double-coated furs refer to a short, soft undercoat and a long, coarser outer coat that protect dogs from extreme weather. Their double coats normally comes in the three following colors: red and white, black and white, gray and white, and on rare occasion you might see a solid white. The Klee-Kai's is typically a clean breed and will tend to groom themselves. Due to their self-care routine, they do not need to bathe as frequently as some other dogs. This breed will blow their coat, meaning that they will lose their undercoat in clumps about twice a year, normally during the summer and winter. During their blowout season, you need to regularly brush their coats as they will be shedding profusely. When it is not blowout season, the Klee-Kai's do some shedding, but their grooming needs are fairly minimal. Nutrition. Alaskan Klee-Kai's need a sufficient diet that will help fuel them through the day and help them maintain calories, since the weight gain for this breed is fairly low due to their energetic nature. There's not a precise diet that is correct for this breed, as every dog is different, and investing in specialized dog food is not needed, as commercial foods have been proven to be just as nutritious. However, you want to make sure to read the nutrition labels. Note that your dog's diet will change throughout their lifetime. What you feed your puppy should be different than what you feed your senior dog. You should always consult your veterinarian or professional nutritionist for insight on how to meet your Alaskan Klee-Kai's individual dietary needs. Health. The lifespan of Alaskan Klee-Kai is about 10 to 13 years, which is about average when compared to similar size breeds. This breed tends to be quite healthy with few genetic traits. However, they are predisposed to certain conditions. Here are some conditions that you should keep an eye out for: luxating patella, thyroid disease, heart conditions, liver shunts, factor 7 deficiency, cataracts. The Klee-Kai is also known to keep their baby teeth, which could cause potential problems when the adult teeth grow in. The baby teeth might need to be removed, and this could create a hefty veterinarian bill. That wraps up the pros of owning the Alaskan Klee-Kai. However, this video would not be complete if we do not mention the cons, as no dog breed is perfect. Now, let's dive into these cons. Separation anxiety. Many dog breeds tend to exhibit separation anxiety, and the Alaskan Klee-Kai is not immune to this trait. Given that these dogs love companionship and want to be around their owner as much as possible, when left alone, some Klee-Kai can become anxious. Some suffer longer than others. It could be 5 minutes or an hour. Separation anxiety can manifest itself in a number of different ways, such as relentless barking, howling or whining, destructive chewing or digging. If you've got a demanding lifestyle that means your Alaskan Klee-Kai will have to be left alone for long spells at home, this may not be the right breed for you. As a dog owner, you can't be around your pup 24/7, nor can you take them everywhere with you. There are multiple ways to solve this separation problem temporarily, such as buying a two-way camera that allows you to talk to your pooch while you are not there in the physical, and you can also leave the dog meditation music playing before you leave them alone. Shyness. As mentioned earlier in the temperament section of this video, some Alaskan Klee-Kai will be skittish around strangers, and you won't be able to take them to places where there are a lot of people, such as dog parks. Some Klee-Kai can even be wary of their own family. One way to overcome shyness is to take your Alaskan Klee-Kai with you everywhere to get them used to unfamiliar people in different situations. Even better if you are able to start socializing them at a young age. Expensive. These pups are going to cost you anywhere between $1,500 and $3,000, but the average price will vary on the individual breeder. So it is safe to say that the Alaskan Klee-Kai are reasonably expensive dogs. Furthermore, the coat color or the eye color could also push the price up. You could probably find this breed for less than market value. However, this is highly recommended against, as you may save money now, but will most likely pay more in the end if you buy an unhealthy pup. As always, you should do your due diligence on finding a reputable breeder and try to see your potential Alaskan Klee-Kai in person. try to steer away from buying online to prevent receiving a puppy mill dog. Shedding. Even though these dogs are fairly clean, you will have to clean up some additional shedding. Vacuuming will become part of your regular routine, especially since this breed does shed regularly. And don't forget about the blowout season, where the Alaskan Klee-Kai will shed their entire inner coat, which can be particularly challenging time. Regular grooming is recommended to keep this issue under control. Escape artist. The Klee-Kai is a very intelligent dog. As mentioned several times, this trait is an advantage to owning this particular breed, but it can also be a downside too. The downside to these smart pooches is that they can sometimes be expert escape artists. If there is a way to escape the house or the yard, there is a pretty good chance they'll find it. As a result, it's recommended that you have your secure fencing to ensure your precious Alaskan Klee-Kai doesn't go missing. They are quite adept at scaling small fences too, while they like to dig, so these dogs could find a route underneath a fence. Some Alaskan Klee-Kai owners will tell you these small to medium-sized dogs don't do well off-leash either. Alaskan Klee-Kai are prey-driven and will chase small animals, such as squirrels and birds. The Alaskan Klee-Kai can be the perfect dog for you if the pros outweigh the cons. You will have to put in the hard work to keep this breed socialized and trained. These dogs are brilliant and lovable and can even talk to you to express how they feel. Some owners of the Alaskan Klee-Kai say that you should be prepared to get plenty of attention from strangers when they see this unique husky breed. Well, that wraps up the video. If you have any other pros and cons about the Alaskan Klee-Kai, please feel free to share it in the comments section. Thank you for watching this video and check out my other playlist on small dog breeds and other videos. The link is below in the description. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the Dog Solid channel. And I will see you in the next video.